If this information had been acted upon, the history of World War II might have been different. The agent was Jiang Yiying, who would later be promoted to the rank of Major General. In the 1940s, such female agents worked in the cities across China. These talented women were trained in Nianbadu, a historic town in southwest Zhejiang Province. Nianbadu is a unique place, with more than 141 family surnames and 13 dialects, perhaps the obvious place to locate a school devoted to covert eavesdropping. Nianbadu is in southwestern Zhejiang Province. It's close to the spot where the borders of Zhejiang, Fujian, and Jiangxi provinces meet. The local people say you can stand in three provinces here. The town boasts the most surnames in China. Among the 3,600 residents, there are 141 surnames and 13 dialects. In the spring of 1941, China's spymaster Dai Li picked Nianbadu as the home of a training center. He would send more than 40 young women from Shanghai, Hangzhou, and other cities to Nianbadu, where they would learn how to eavesdrop on enemy communications. The clandestine telecommunication interception training center was only for women. Dai Li was a cautious man and chose Nianbadu because of its origin, dialects, and surnames. More than 1,000 years ago, during a rebellion, a peasant army opened a new route into Fujian. The road between Zhejiang and Fujian passed through Nianbadu. The strategic location of the town made it an ideal spot to build a fortress. The village hall was one of the earliest buildings in Nianbadu. At one time, 1,500 soldiers of the Qing dynasty were stationed here. Having a military garrison stationed here was good for business. In the early Ming Dynasty, a family with the name of Liu from Fujian province became the earliest civilian immigrants here. More people came and settled in the town. By around 1900, the total number of local surnames grew to more than 80.
This is our village records. 我们念巴都有140多个姓，光我们巡礼村就有100多个姓，最多的姓氏有800多个人，最少的姓氏一个人。A
survey in 2005 recorded 141 surnames in Nianbadu. Four of them include over 500 people. They're Chen, Dai, Wang, and Li.
这140个姓氏呢，有的来是浙江的，有的来是江西的，有的来是福建的，最远的是从福建沿海，汕州那边过来的。
85-year-old Yang Qingshan is considered to be a walking encyclopedia of Nianbadu. His ancestors moved here about 400 years ago. The road through Nianbadu connected to the Maritime Silk Road, so the town became popular. 100 years ago, it had been the busiest market in the region. Dai Li chose Nianbadu as a training center for agents because of its geography. The Japanese invaded much of China, but they never captured this town. Located in rugged mountains, Nianbadu has survived many battles. Its architecture, representative of the Ming and Qing dynasties, remains intact.
我们现在来到的就是念巴都独具特色的一个小弄堂，它的名字呢叫做回音壁。为什么叫回音壁呢？因为这里啊，您说一句话或者是击个掌，都会产生不一样的回音效果。
Nianbadu had plenty of merchants and travelers passing through, so the locals took little notice of strangers. The women who would be trained as agents would go unnoticed.
You see, my house is some old things. I like these things. 你看这张床也不错，这个床是清末的，这是象牙镶嵌，它这个图案呢是杨家将打仗的图案。我们杨家的是清朝的时候，嘉庆年嵌到这里的，所以我们到了这里以后，不忘祖宗，这个你看做家具的时候把这个图案也贴进去，就怀念祖宗。
Yang Jian San says he's a descendant of Yang Ji Ye, an ancient hero from Sanxi Province. For the past 20 years, he's collected over 2,000 items used in daily life during the Ming and Qing dynasties.
This thing is used for drinking wine. It's in a bowl, two drinks. This is air conditioned. It's put in the wine. 把米酒炖好以后炖热了，那有些人呢，他喜欢喝烧酒，那烧酒呢冬天喝太凉，那怎么办呢？他又不能炖，所以就倒进去。打了两转以后出来，它酒是热的，但是倒一杯喝一杯。这个时候扶住它，不要它动，你斜一点，这个时候往下，你拉的越开越下去，水量越大。
Yang Jian San has collected fire nozzles from the Qing dynasty. Such items show the local wealth of people back then. Zhu Dohua loves singing and playing musical instruments. Every weekend, he performs in his doorway. He's known as the happiest man in town. Zhu Dohua's family moved here from Jiangxi. In addition to singing Jiangxi opera, he's good at imitating the local dialects. he can imitate a dozen of the dialects found in Nianbadu. The people of Nianbadu are proud of their many dialects. The mix of people and languages brought here over the centuries created a unique community that proved attractive to China's spy master. The different dialects do not hinder communication. People speak their own dialect at home and speak a local Mandarin out in the community. Knowledge of different dialects can be very useful in times of war. During the Second World War, U.S. military messages in the Pacific were often decoded by the Japanese. Later, the U.S. used native Navajo Indians to code transmissions in their language. The U.S. forces were able to communicate securely. Chinese spymaster Dai Li also used difficult dialects to encrypt his most confidential transmissions. Dai's hometown is Baoan, a village near Nianbadu. He designed this house in 1943, and even his closest aide knew nothing about the hidden passages even after living there for 3 years. Dai Li hired local people to encrypt top secret information. They delivered military messages and difficult to decode Jiangshan dialects. For Dai Li, however, the accents could be a big problem for agents. They might expose themselves by speaking with an accent. Still, Nianbadu, with tens of dialects, was an ideal place for offering language training to new agents. Dai Li reportedly chose Nianbadu as the training base for agents because of its cultural variety. He thought the women could become familiar with different customs quickly in such a place. It would be useful, as they might be assigned different roles later on. Sliding stones is a local game. The soldiers stationed here centuries ago are said to have invented this game to add some excitement to their lives and to build their strength.
We were several years old when the Guangxi Guangxi was hit. We were from the bottom of the ground. In the middle, the ground hit us to hit us. The ground hit us to hit us. The ground hit us to hit us to hit us. It was hit us. 4个人一组，6个人一组，还9个人一组。
Nianbadu is known for its cultural variety. Local people came here from different places and display their individual cultural identity. But all are treated equally. They still practice unique folk arts, such as dancing, making lanterns, paper cutting, puppets, stilt walking, and others. Nianbadu's folk arts and customs feature traditional styles from Shandong and Henan in North China, or Yunnan and Guizhou in Southwest China. You can experience the customs of local mountain villages as well as coastal areas far away. Among the local surnames are many related to food. You can find family names meaning firewood, rice, oil, salt, sauce, vinegar, and tea. The people still maintain their own inherited traits. Visitors can sample cuisine from different places in China. One famous delicacy is the local tofu. It's said that many of the women who are being trained as agents took a liking to it and even learned how to make it. The story goes that many of them used the disguise of a tofu vendor in other cities. Even if the story is not true, it certainly helps promote Nianbadu tofu. The tofu is still made in the traditional method. People first select quality soybeans, soak them in water overnight, and then grind them on a stone. After boiling and filtering the bean milk, people add gypsum. Smart locals label their tofu with the story of the female agents to attract tourists. Once a fortress guarding a strategic route between Zhejiang and Fujian provinces, the old town of Nianbadu is now a top tourist attraction. Nianbadu has plenty to offer visitors. The traditional artists here conserve their folk culture and natural interests. They are actively engaged in preserving local history. Song Mu Sun owns a clothing shop. He also sells his goods online and makes additional money posing for pictures with tourists. Nianbadu is a place of contrasts. In addition to a mix of dialects, there are old chimneys beside modern solar heaters on roofs. Some people still use fans to cool off, but the others switch on air conditioners. Brick houses and new concrete buildings stand alongside one another on the streets. The old and the new come together to make Nianbadu one of the wonderful old towns of China.